keep that, because in 3 years' time, it will be completely outdated. I first met Kevin and Max in 2019. At that time, I was the CEO of a much larger company, and they asked me to join the board of TreeFrog. And I must say, at first, I was a bit skeptical about the real potential of technology. So they asked me to challenge the team. And the more I was digging into it, the more I've been convinced that this was the technology that could really change the cell therapy market. One is the scale, the second is the quality of cells we obtain, and the third one is the nature of the 3D objects we can make, the microtissues. First, the scale. Earlier this year, we published the fact that we were able to make in 1 week, one batch of 15 billion of cells. Well, it was a world premiere, and it's a first step to where we're going now in terms of scaling the manufacturing. And it's very important because in some diseases, like liver diseases or heart diseases or even diabetes, you will need billions of cells per patient. In other diseases where you will need maybe less cells, you have so many patients that at the end we will need hundreds of billions of cells. Second aspect is quality. In system, what we've shown is that even though we can expand the cells very broadly, we keep the quality of the cells. From the beginning to the end, the cells remain the same. Third aspect, new products. With system, we can make new type of microtissues. For instance, our program in Parkinson's disease, we are the only one in the world to be able to handle mature neurons and graft them in the brain. We just raised $75 million. That's 10 times what we raised 2.5 years ago. So we're going to do 10 times more with the money we have. And thanks to our new investors, BPI, the French Sovereign Fund, Leonard Green Partners, a $50 billion fund under management, and also our strategic partner BMS, the world leader in immuno-oncology. Those are long-term investors that will support us to grow the business and deploy the technology. The aim is simple. We will expand the use of our technology through partnerships. We'll invest here in Bordeaux. We'll also open a new lab in Boston in the US and a lab in Kobe in Japan to be close to where cell therapy is happening now. We will reinforce our scientific teams with the aim to create a pipeline of therapeutic opportunities in neurology, I mentioned Parkinson's disease, in cardiology, in hepatology, and more recently in immuno-oncology. Our goal is to have our first product tested in human in 2024.